I'm here at Uber's test facilities in Pittsburgh. This week, the company began picking up passengers in specially equipped autonomous vehicles. Let's go take a ride. Beginning today, a select group of Pittsburgh Uber users will get a surprise the next time they request a pickup: the option to ride in a self-driving car. At a press conference, an Uber executive called the city the double black diamond of driving because of its tricky weather and irregular grid, making it an especially interesting place to test the service.
Pittsburgh is home to world-class research and engineering talent. It has an organic road network. It has real traffic conditions. Uber started the ATC 18 months ago with the specific purpose of getting self-driving vehicles onto the road, so I'm so excited that you guys are going to be some of the first people in our self-driving fleet.
A hail to ride from Uber's regular app, though Pittsburgh users who book an UberX won't know if they get an autonomous car until it shows up. Once in the back of the car, I touched a button on a tablet to say I was ready to go. The tablet showed me a live view of the car's vision, blue for the road, red for objects. Two engineers sat in the front seats taking notes and poised to take over if something went wrong. I felt a little nervous the first time the car encountered an obstacle. You don't notice how many unexpected things happen on the road until you ask a robot to take the wheel. But the drive was so consistent, it quickly felt like a normal car ride. The car read traffic light colors and stopped for one yellow light while driving through a different yellow light. It edged around other cars and stopped for pedestrians. Then the engineers let me drive the car back to the Uber campus. Once a light turned blue on the dash, I could hit a silver button in the center console to go autonomous. Braking, accelerating, or hitting a red button brought driving back under my control. We went manual several times to drive around stopped cars, because otherwise the Uber would just stop behind them and wait. Sometimes it was gentle, sometimes it came to a lurching halt. It felt a lot like riding in a car with a human driver. At no point did Uber suggest the technology found in its cars is ready to roll out to the masses. Like Google and many other labs developing self-driving technology, it's carefully logging hours of road tests. Its team is slowly working its way through a long list of scenarios its cars should be prepared to respond to in the wild. Pittsburgh passengers are new scenarios Uber can introduce into its research. Uber will also have to pay close attention to public opinion. This is the first time the world has seen such a large fleet of autonomous cars in one city. A lot of people will have their first ride-along experience, which should promote enough awareness to gauge if people are warming up to autonomous cars.